Wait, this disappeared. Something to keep in mind. Look at that. I love the glow. Let's play in some makeup. I have this L'Oreal True Match Nude Hyaluronic Tinted Serum, and this is the shade 10 to 12, which is so strange. I mean, it's called 10 to 12, which is interesting. They got 8 to 10, 10.5 to 11, 8.5 to 9.5. This is 10 to 12, so let's see. I think this will match me. I can already tell that it's going to be darker than my skin tone right now, but when it all comes together, it should look good. We're gonna find that out. Based on the name, this is great if you have dry skin. It says here that it's good for oily skin too. Sensitive and dry and oily. So everybody, although it has hyaluronic acid. So if you don't want to be even more hydrated with your foundation, I can't imagine that you would enjoy this. But they say here that you could wear it, but do you want to? Is it your preference to be more hydrated than you already are? That's up to you to decide. It says here that it's also good for acne prone skin. It's supposed to leave the skin smoother, more hydrated. It's gonna give lightweight coverage. It's supposed to illuminate, which I do believe because it has some bronzer in it, which is so strange, like this silver bronzer. It's a makeup and skincare hybrid. And again, this is a tinted serum and it's $14.99. So I've already got my skincare on and my SPF. I'm not going to prime my face. I just want to put this on and see what happens. Let's see how much coverage this gives. All products are going to be linked below. This is a Sigma flat kabuki brush. It has a light scent to it. Ah, oh, wait, this disappeared. It looks like nothing. Now, mind you, I do have a breakout. I have rosacea, and every now and then I have these rashes on my face. That's what's happening right now, but we still move. Rosacea is a chronic condition, and I am treating it with a prescription. It is nice and deep in a great way. I would say that this is more medium to, like, light to medium coverage. What in the world? If you like a light to medium coverage situation, I feel like you would enjoy this. Let's see how this looks when built up a little bit. Let me just do this. I'm not gonna, I mean, this is mine. I'm not gonna cross contaminate. Could I have gone lighter perhaps? But when the face is all said and done, I like to start off with a darker shade. Okay, I'm pouncing it on so not to wipe it because this is giving me medium coverage. I can still see my skin right here. It's a little light. So the pouncing does help with that. It is giving glow. I mean, you can tell from the bottle that there's a glow inside this, so that's not a secret. I know it looks really dark. If you're new here, it's gonna all come together. Don't worry, don't worry. Don't be alarmed. Covered my brows nicely. Interesting. I must say that when I do have my breakouts, and even you can see here in the middle of my face, my skin goes through this resurfacing process where this has to heal. And then when it's healed, it's going to then shed. So it ends up making my skin feel really dry. So using hydrating complexion products during this process actually is better for me. So this feels comfortable right now. I know that later on in the day, I'm going to be looking even more dewy. I'll have to focus on the whole blotting of the face. But if your skin is chronically dry or chronically dehydrated, and or you just enjoy a glowy finish, this is definitely a great option for you. And if you're my skin tone, if you're gonna use this one, be prepared for it to be really dark on you, unless you wanted to go with the shade 8 to 10. Although to me, 8 to 10 looks way too light, but it's worth a try. This is the LYX Beauty Concealer. The shade is DG6, and you'll see how with highlighting and then contouring to bring back the shadow, the whole face is gonna come together. I do have to note also, because I'm noticing, even though I've done my concealer and I'm now gonna contour with this LYS Beauty Worthy Stick Bronzer, it got darker outside too, by the way, if you're wondering why the place looks different, is that because my skin is going through this situation with this breakout and it feels drier than normal, the foundation's not gonna wear on me the way that it would if my skin were not going through this issue. Do you understand what I'm saying? Depending on the time of year, depending on the state of your skin, if not changed, meaning if you do not change your foundation, the same foundation or tinted serum or skin tint, what have you, will look different. So that's something to keep in mind. Because right now I'm sitting here like, why don't I feel and look more dewy? Well, my skin is on the drier side because of this outbreak. Oh, the breakout, you feel me? So something to keep in mind. This is a Sephora 56 brush that I'm using to blend my contour with. I have this new Milk Makeup Pore Eclipse Setting Powder, and this is the shade Translucent Medium. It's a loose setting powder. It's supposed to give a filtered finish, no talc, no silicone, no cakiness, no messy spills, no flashback, the whole nine yards. There are four different shades. I'm gonna use this one under my eyes, not on my face, because my face, like I said, feels more dry than normal. I was gonna use the brush that it comes with, and this is really fluffy and delicious looking, but it's just too huge to put under the eye. But this will be a great brush to use on the face. Under the eye, I'm gonna use this LYS concealer brush. I like this a lot. Let's get some of the products in the cap, put some back, and see what's left. Oh, I'm in a little bit of a mess, okay? Let's see what's left over. We're gonna apply this directly under the eyes first, because you know I like to do my luminous setting powder elsewhere under my eyes. Lovely, looks good. I can tell that this is very mattifying. If my skin wasn't feeling so dry, I was actually gonna use all four of these on my face, but it's gonna make my face feel way too dry, not what I want at all today. Choose your products based on how your skin looks and feels. That is huge. Glow Wish by Huda. This is the medium tan luminous press powder, and this is a Sigma E60 blending brush. Honestly and truly, I don't even need to set this concealer. When I was looking at it, I was like, this joint looks good already, but I just want that highlighted look under my eyes. So that's the only reason why I'm doing it. But it looked so good without me having to do this. What I will say about this powder is that it's not a banana, all right? It's definitely a medium, giving more of a beige off-white sentiment. Just as an FYI, it didn't add color to my face, I won't say, but certainly did set it and keep it light, but it's not gonna give you a banana, you feel what I'm saying? But I do like it. I'm feeling very stiff right now. Let's finish the contour and then spray the face, because I need some more hydration right now. Let's spray this face because I'm feeling more dry than I need to. So this is the NYX Dewy Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. Already the face is looking so good, especially the highlight. Look at it, just looks so much better now that it's dewy, you know? Oh my gosh, my face feels so much more comfortable. Look at that. I love the glow. The Luminous Setting Powder from Huda, love it. And my skin looks and feels a whole lot better. I did powder my face with the Cloud Set from Kosas, you saw that. Let's do brows. For the eyes, I'm gonna use this Maybelline Color Tattoo 24-Hour Eye Stick. This is new and the shade is 40. I am fierce. Now before I use this, this is a beautiful goldy olive type color. I'm going to put my crease color together first, because sometimes if you do the crease after you do the lid color, it just gets really messy. So let's start off with this chocolate brown palette from Huda Beauty and take this reddish brown color. I always use a reddish brown color in my crease. So the crease is the area right here between your eyeball and your brow bone. And then let's deepen this with this darker brown color, because we're using an olive green color. Really any color that I use, honestly, I'm still gonna deepen this crease in with, but certainly because this color is gonna pop on the lid, it'll just look so much better, more delicious if this crease is dark. Now, I would never just do the brown and not the reddish brown, because I need this crease to have a transition to it. It'll look so much prettier on brown skin when you have a transition color. And that reddish brown color is really the middleman between this brown and the brow bone highlight. Here's a shadow stick, and I'm gonna put this on dry eyes. No eyeshadow base. And this really could be used as an eyeshadow base. You can put something on top of this, but we just gonna do this by itself. And I like that it's already pointy, so it'll help to outline this lid and make it look like we have a cut crease. Do you see that? It's already giving cut crease, because you already have the darker color, so it contrasts with it so perfectly. Boom, look at that. What? makes life easy. Now, this part is not as sharp, but we gonna still try to get an outline. Look how creamy this is and reflective. I have not done an olive green color like this in a very long time. Now, the olive green up against this brown is making the brown look purple. Trying to get it to be equal. Ooh, this is where the challenge comes in, honey. And I'm not gonna bring this all the way to the end because I do want there to be a gradient when I apply my crease color more in the corners. Lovely. Would you wear this eyeshadow color? Comment and let me know. Now let's get some of this reddish brown in the corner and then the dark brown. This is the Give Beauty 24 Hour Gel Eyeliner in the shade Spiderwebs. I'm gonna put this inside my waterline and on top and then smudge that out. Lashes are on. These are ones from AliExpress and sometimes they be acting up, okay? But we gonna let them be where they are, okay? Face still feels like I could use some more hydration. Let's get a little more on. This is a good spray. It's just my skin needs it. Focusing more on the bottom half of my skin since I don't wanna make my eye makeup wet, you feel me? And the forehead is fine, just the bottom half where I have the majority of the breakout. I almost forgot my blush. I was just overzealous. Let's do the highlighter before the blush. This is the Rare Beauty Luminizer. We definitely wanna do the nose. Definitely wanna go right under, right up top here. I'm not gonna do my chin since I can see the glow and the rashes, just no need to exacerbate that any further. Let's do Denise Myrick's Golden Hour. I love this blush. What? Butt of the Beauty Sponge. All products are linked below. We're gonna focus on the apples of the cheek and make our way back. Beautiful, gorgeous. And lippy, I'm gonna do a combo that I've never done before because I haven't used these two products before, but this liner I have and I love it a lot. This is the LYX lip liner in the shade Devoted. So brown girl friendly. Milk Cosmetics sent me these lip and cheek products. I had them a while ago, but I didn't have all these different shades. This is Enigma. And like I said, it can go on the lip or the cheek. What I love is that some of them actually have on there for you to twist because they have a contour product that when I used it, I just popped it off and then a piece of the product came off. So twist and then pull up. So this is Enigma. It can go on lips and cheek. Obviously on my cheek, this is not gonna show. Let's see what it looks like on the lip. Wow. This is very soft. How would this even show on the cheek? You'd have to be very fair for this to show on the cheek, obvi. Interesting. Pretty. It's a neutral nude. It's not warm. Neutral, meaning more gray. I would call it a cool nude. I wouldn't even call it neutral. It smells nice. It smells nice and sweet. I enjoy it. I was gonna put a gloss on top, but I enjoy this just by itself. It's not loud. I wanted it lighter, I have to say. I was gonna put on top this Odyssey Lip Oil Gloss from Milk that was also sent to me. This is the shade Soul Search. But I don't, maybe I should. Maybe it'll give me a little bit of a pink. With a nice scent to it. I mean, this is more of a satin. Let's just do it. I want to brighten this up. Let's see if this works. A little bit. Okay, it made it a little pink, obvi. Pretty. All right, it's a look. Comment and let me know what you think about it. Have you tried these products? Do you plan on it? What do you think about this eye look? It is different. Let me know if you like it. All links are below and I will see you in the next video. There are two videos here to choose from. Pick one and watch the next one. I've got playlists here on my channel as well. Follow me on all socials and I will see you in the next video. Bye.